So this has been a big challenge for us, medically speaking. This has been a very tough case. We did a surgery to try and get in there and understand better what was causing the obstruction within her sinuses. As we got into that surgery, we realized we were dealing with a really significant infection. So an impacted tooth, if you think of an impacted wisdom tooth in a person, very much the same thing. That was the source of a lot of the infection and the swelling that we were dealing with. I think it's been very uncomfortable for her. It's sort of the toothache coupled with the inability to move air normally. Rhinos normally breathe exclusively through their nose, so it's been very difficult for her even to kind of learn how to breathe through her mouth. Our best guess is that in the wild, this is not a condition she would have been able to survive. She was having significant challenges moving air normally, significant problems breathing. So in order for us to be able to get in and remove that tissue was really made a life-saving change for her. Yeah, she's a very beloved animal for sure. She's got a fantastic care staff that's incredibly devoted to her. We all really want to see the best for her and want to get her through this illness. Very important animal from a conservation standpoint. Rhinos are in a lot of trouble right now in the wild. Poaching has drastically decreased their numbers in the past 10 to 20 years, and every animal is a very important animal right now. She's still very young, so she's got the opportunity to contribute a lot of offspring to the global population of rhinos. We were just at a breeding age basically with her when this problem set in, so our hope is that we can get this problem cleared up and she can go on to have a number of calves and live a very long, happy life.